Greetings, members of the Milky Way Galaxy. I'm Anyu, also known as Grey Matter Fanboy, and in today's video, we'll be ranking every classic Ben 10 alien. And stick around to the end of the video for a brand new announcement for my new series. Let's go! The criteria we'll be using for this tier list video are combat ability, which is how well they do in fights, especially against major villains, versatility, which is the limit of how creative you can get with the alien, and also their escape score, how well they're able to leave a fight if it becomes too challenging. Our first alien is Forearms. Now, this alien possesses a high combat ability, being able to take on incredibly advanced mechanical humanoids and even mutant bloodlusting mammoths. He possesses a high level of versatility, as his abilities range from a sonic clap to super strength. Along with these factors, he has a great escape score because of his enhanced jumping ability, enabling him to leave and enter a situation quickly. This lands him in S tier, as his abilities are very well rounded, making him a super efficient and even a go-to transformation for almost any situation. Now for an alien that I recently covered in my DNA analysis, which is Ditto. His combat ability is pretty decent, being able to coordinate and take down fully grown adult men. Along with that, his main duplication ability allows him to be very versatile with how he fights, bringing his strength in numbers. His ability to escape a fight is pretty low, however, as he was able to be captured by Dr. Animo in his first appearance. I'd place him on the E rank, because even though his abilities are pretty decent, what he has to offer can easily be done, or even be done better, by another alien. Our next alien is Frankenstrike. Now, his combat ability is pretty good, as he was able to fight off the Scare, Victor, and the Mummy. Even though he had help, that does take a decent amount of skill to pull off. I wouldn't count his versatility as that high, as his abilities are mainly electromagnetism and electrokinesis. Being limited by this inability to absorb electricity, he also has a very low escape score. As he isn't that fast, neither does he possess any other notable traits that help him to leave a fight. This lands him in C tier, as his abilities would be counted as mid-range or average compared to the aliens previously listed. Now moving on to Wildvine. This alien has a pretty decent combat ability, being able to take on a wild Lemoan with relative ease and a highly skilled Kane North as well, being able to use his vines to swing long distances and use explosive seeds that he produces from his back, along with camouflaging himself in other plants. With his camouflage and vine manipulation abilities, he can easily escape a large majority of Ben's enemies. Keeping him well-rounded and this high level of versatility, Wildvine would be a little bit less than A tier, as his combat ability holds him back from being able to fight bigger threats. Diamond Head, Ben's Crystal Sapient alien, has a really good combat ability, being able to take on various advanced and even giant robots, and also the Mummy. Diamond Head has a variety of abilities, with its crystal kinesis being able to shoot and control crystals in a multitude of ways, making him incredibly versatile. His ability to escape a fight, however, is not very good, but his combat ability and incredible versatility makes up for it. This lands him in A tier, as Diamond Head is an incredible combat threat, but if the fight gets too rough, there might not be any room for him to escape. An underrated alien, Ripjaws has an immaculate specialty. Having his strength come from being submerged underwater, his combat ability is pretty high, as he's able to take on swarms of advanced squid-like robots that have been designed for underwater combat, and even fight fully grown humans in vehicles on land. He has a pretty standard and straightforward alien, as he draws most of his strength from being underwater and also having his strong metal bending jaws. Because of this specialty, he doesn't possess a lot of versatility, and his escape score is pretty good as long as he's underwater, as his speed and control is unparalleled. Even with all of these abilities, he's significantly disadvantaged on land. This lands him in D tier, as he requires special conditions to use his full potential. Moving on to Ben's Gorman form, Upchuck, which is another pretty unique alien. He has a decent combat ability, being able to take on super advanced Vilgax drones and also soloing the Forever King. Upchuck has a lot of feats. He's also relatively versatile, being able to eat and regurgitate energy along with being able to consume literally anything. His escape score is pretty abysmal, as he isn't very capable of leaving large-scale fights. He, however, makes up for this with his main ability, since he can almost always eat his way out of any situation. I'd only place him in C tier, because he isn't the most capable of all the aliens in the Omnitrix. Ben's Lepidopteran form has a pretty average combat ability, having not defeated major villains that Ben has faced, besides normal humans. He possesses a high level of versatility, with his tail in slime, as he is able to stop fires and even stop a helicopter from crashing with the substance. His flight, however, is his greatest strength, as it not only gives him an excellent escape score, but being able to arrive and leave almost any situation. With all of these abilities, I'd place him in B tier. Though he's incredibly versatile, his lackluster combat ability holds him back from reaching a higher rank. Ben's smartest alien and a race that originated the Omnitrix, Grey Matter. Now, this alien has a pretty low combat ability. Unless his opponent is mechanical, in any way, he doesn't have much to offer, being oppressed by even a house cat. He, however, has excellent versatility, as he is a genius, being able to understand machines that he has never seen before, and also a genius in overall intellect. His escape score is also abysmal, as he was even captured by an average human. With all of these factors, I'd place him in D tier along with Ripjaws, as this transformation requires specific conditions to be of optimal use. Moving to Galvan Prime's moon, we have Ben's Techno-Organic Slime upgrade. Now, his combat ability is excellent, being able to take on the transforming wizard Kenko in the video game simulation, and also beating all three circus freaks by himself. His versatility is excellent, as he is able to possess and control and upgrade any kind of technology. This ability directly feeds into his escape score, as he can use this to leave and arrive at any situation with ease, as long as tech is near him. I place this alien in A tier, as his power is clearly able to thrive on a technological society like Earth, hence leaving him with limitless options for combat. He's unable to take on larger foes on the fly without larger resources. Revisiting the inner system, we have the alien Ben Mummy or Snero. He has an average combat ability, as in Ben's first transformation, he struggles to fight the Laboan, who is in allegiance with the Scare. However so, he has an excellent level of versatility, as he's able to manipulate his bandages to no end. With all these factors, he would net a higher rank, but his bandages are pretty weak and can easily be torn by anyone with sharp claws or enhanced strength. Hence, I place him in C tier. Aye guys, Ben's next alien. Now, our guy has a high bar for combat skills, being able to put up a fantastic fight against the negative 10, being able to even one-shot one of them, and also being able to take on one of Animo's mutants by himself in Secret of the Omnitrix. He possesses a wide variety of abilities, as his eyes not only give him 360-degree vision, but a variety of eye beams, including fire, ice, and even lasers, giving him an excellent arsenal for any fight. With these abilities, it gives him an average escape score, since not all major villains are susceptible to his abilities. This would land him in B tier, because even though he has such a large arsenal of beams, these aren't always the most effective against major villains. Moving on from Eye Guy, we have one of Ben's most unique aliens, Cannonbolt. Now, his combat ability is next level, being able to take on the likes of a fully mutated Kevin 11 and single-handedly defeating the Great One already shows his high level of combat prowess. He also has a high level of versatility, from being able to ricochet with ease all the way to re-entering Earth's atmosphere unscathed. His escape score is also pretty decent, as his ball form can enter and leave any situation at great speeds. I'd place him in S tier, as he's a very well-rounded alien. Another inner alien snarls into this tier list, and that is Ben Wolf, or Blitzwolfer. Now, his combat ability is pretty good. We don't get to see a lot from him, but he is able to go toe-to-toe with Wildvine and Cannonbolt in their own individual fights. He's pretty versatile. Beyond all generic enhancements, his Sonic Howl can be used in many ways, beyond just as a long-range attack. And his escape score is also really good, being able to escape a numerous amount of times from Ben Tennyson himself. I'd however place him in C tier, as many an alien can be placed on this tier list that can do his job better. Staying in the inert system, we have the only alien that got away, Ghost Freak. Now this alien has superb combat ability, being able to take on all three Circus Freaks with ease, almost being counted as overkill. But also, his abilities to become intangible and invisible and to possess his opponents make him nearly undefeatable. These abilities also add to his versatility, bringing his defensive strength to the same level as his offensive strength. Combined with such an incredible balance, Ghost Freak is able to enter and leave any situation with utmost ease, even the Omnitrix. This lands him in S tier, as this alien used at its max potential is nearly undefeatable. Now, moving out of the darkness and into the light, we have Ben's blazing alien, Heat Blast. Now, this alien possesses an incredible combat ability, being able to take on hordes of Vilgax drones and facing down the squid-faced giant himself. Heat Blast's pyrokinetic abilities make him one of the most versatile aliens in Ben's arsenal. These abilities also aid his escape score, as Heat Blast was even able to escape from Vilgax with almost great ease. I'd rank this alien in S tier, as his well-rounded abilities and immaculate control can net him a win over almost any big bad in the series. Now zooming by is Accelerate. This alien has an incredible combat ability, being able to take out entire SWAT teams and even going toe-to-toe with corrodium-enhanced mutants. His versatility is as high as his speed, as he's even able to run on water. Now, with previously stated facts, you can hopefully already tell that he is an alien with immediate escapes for any situation. I'd however rank him as an A tier. Being held back by his combat ability, Accelerate is unable to take on major threats like Vilgax and even Rojo. Coming in with his essential smell is Wildmutt. Now, he has a pretty average combat ability, with feats ranging from taking on Vilgax drones to destroying an enchanted digger. He also has a pretty good situational versatility, as he does not require light to see, making him a huge threat in darkness. Along with that, he has a serious escape score, as his quadrupedalism aids his speed in making a grand entrance and escape. I'd land this alien in B tier, as he's able to be a threatening force, but is still dwarfed by the other aliens in the roster. Lastly, making a giant step into battle is Ben's largest alien, Waybig. Now, his combat ability is unparalleled in the Omnitrix, being able to easily defeat Vilgax, his own greatest enemy. His versatility is incredibly high, with him being a giant and also possessing a cosmic laser ability. His escape score follows up as almost unnecessary. Beyond the fact that he could cover miles in a few steps, Waybig rarely needs to escape any fights. This lands Waybig in S tier, as he's an overwhelming threat to anyone who tries to defeat the Tennyson family. Now, this is my tier list for all classic Ben 10 aliens. Please share your opinions down below in the comments, whether you disagree or agree with my placements. And I'll also be starting a new series where I take submitted fights from scenes of the series and review what alien is the most efficient for Ben to use, called Omnitrix Efficiency. Now, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Hey there, members of the Milky Way Galaxy. If you'd like to support the continuation of this series, you can purchase this Galvin Brain Fact t-shirt. And you can also follow me on Instagram. Both links are in the description.